There is a history between the businesses. Airbus has spent $400 million between 2005 and 2013 with the two companies. They have been providing components on the Airbus military and commercial aircraft range, and this is seen as taking the arrangement to the next level.
It means we can go for much bigger work packages than they've traditionally been able to win, and that's the plan. But I think beyond that, it gives us a 10-year roadmap to work with industry and government to really develop South African aerospace industry.
Well, we felt as companies that there's a great deal of complementarity between us and very little overlap, in fact. So it was a quite obvious thing for us to do, to pull our forces together, because by doing that, we will be better accessing the international global marketplace.
For us, this is a very important milestone. We've made great progress in maturing our industrial capability. We believe we now have a solid reputation in terms of on time, on quality, on cost deliveries. For us, this MOU opens up a new chapter.
The demand for new airlines continues to increase, and it's estimated some 30,000 new planes will be needed in the next 20 years. To meet this requirement, the South African aerospace industry and several government departments began developing new technology and materials several years ago. The Council for Scientific and Industrial Research has been developing research and technology projects focused on 3D printing, advanced flight control systems, and the use of titanium. But government involvement is essential.
It's absolutely critical because, you know, we're pushing a strategic vision in South Africa from the three parties around niche manufacturing technologies, and the support to R&T and the support to the cost base of South Africa is absolutely critical. I mean, we can do our bit in industry, but the government also has to play its part in facilitating and making the right environment, stable environment in which to operate.
Skills development and employment remain a key consideration. High-level skills are required to manufacture the components required. Aerosud, for example, has already contributed components to 7,000 flying Airbus 320s and Boeing 737s.
Aerosud already has around 850 staff members. And I must really stress here that these persons, all of them, are either engineers or technicians or skilled artisans or operators. We just simply do not employ unskilled labor.
The South African aerospace industry is set to get a major boost with the signing of this agreement. But for it to work properly and to be sustainable, it's essential that government involvement in terms of research and development is maintained. I'm Angelo Coppola for CCTV outside OR Tambo International Airport.